In this video, I'll be talking about car dealerships and how they rip you off without you even knowing. And overcharging you for a car isn't the only way that car dealerships rip you off. Sure, they may purchase a car for $10,000, for example, and then they try to sell you that same car for $25,000, and that's expected, but there are a couple sneaky ways in which they try to make you feel as if you're getting more value for your money, but in reality, they're just ripping you off even more. So if you want to learn more about how they do this, then stick around to the very end of this video so you can find out how they do it and then avoid being ripped off by car dealers in the future. Now, if you've ever been ripped off by a car dealer before, comment below and let me know. And also, how did they rip you off? I'm curious to know. Also, before I tell you how they're able to pull this off over and over again, a very quick reminder here, if you are new to this channel and you're watching one of my videos for the very first time, my name is Ian, and I post videos here on YouTube every single day on topics relating to making money and personal finance. So if you'd like to see more of these videos, then give this video a thumbs up. I'll really appreciate it. And also consider subscribing to this channel and turning on all the notifications. And that way you'll be able to get the updates every day when I post a new video here. Now, the first way car dealers rip you off is by offering you that walk-in and we'll finance you right here deal. It sounds good and it's probably convenient, but this is one way that car dealers make money. They actually get a commission each time you purchase using their preferred lender or finance company, and this is why car dealers are now offering in-house financing. They have someone at the dealership who is ready to give you a loan, so you don't ever have to leave the dealership without the car that they want you to purchase. Now, usually the in-house financing ends up being a bit more expensive if you were to do it somewhere else. And by the way, I don't recommend buying a new car or at least financing one, because the first 3 years are the worst 3 years, right? On average, and this depends on the car, of course, but on average, the first 3 years accounts for about 52% of the overall depreciation of the car. So you're taking most of the depreciation in the first 3 years. Whoever buys that car at year four is going to have very little depreciation on that car. If you try to sell it after a year, chances are you'll be upside down in that loan, because now you have a car that you paid 50K for and it's only worth 35K. And if you sell it, you'd be on the hook for the entire amount. So buy used, and actually this isn't expert advice, right? Do what you want, but I wouldn't purchase a new car unless I were buying it cash, because then I would be purchasing it because I actually liked it. I could afford to purchase it cash without it affecting me, and I guess I would just have money to blow. So that's how they rip you off firstly. Now, these car loans are also a ripoff by themselves because they only tell you about the payments. Don't worry about the sticker price. That's what the sales associate will tell you. They'll tell you that it's only going to cost you $199.99 per month, which is very affordable, but you'll be stuck with a loan for 72 months. That's 6 years. You're giving away $200 every single month for the next 6 years. Double that number, and that could easily be the same amount of time it takes you to purchase a house on a 15-year mortgage. Now, if that car is new, in 6 years, you'll be lucky if you can get 30% off the sticker price back, and that's not even considering the interest of about 6% per year, which then adds up to a couple thousand more. So instant in-house financing, low or no down payments, low monthly payments, it all sounds good, but it's a trap to get you to pay interest and fees for almost half a decade or even more than half a decade. Now, the second way that car dealers rip you off is by selling you cars. If it's a used car or pre-owned car, then they're going to try to rip you off. And this is where you have to do all your due diligence and research, because I could sell cars and there could be a lot across the street from me, and I could have a car selling for $25,000. And then the lot across the street has the same model, year, options, similar mileage, and they have it for $20,000, which is a fair price. But if you never did your research on the fair price for that particular car, then you wouldn't know and you'll overpay. And of course, the dealer isn't going to tell you that the car is overpriced. Their job is to actually rip you off and see how much you can pay and charge you the maximum amount possible. So if you're looking at buying a used or pre-owned car, you can use tools like Kelley Blue Book and put the car details in, such as make, model, year, color, the options, mileage, and location. And it will give you three prices: a good deal price, fair market price and also overpriced. Also, you can just go on a website that has cars like Carfax and look at what the cars sell for at different lots in your area, and you'll get an idea of what the car is worth. Now, if you're purchasing a new car, the same applies. Don't just look at the MSRP and listen to the dealer and think you're getting a good deal. They don't purchase cars in singles from the manufacturer. They purchase hundreds at a time. They can actually get the cars way below MSRP, which means they mark up the price, or when they mark up the price, you can still negotiate and get a deal on that car. Your best bet is to shop at different dealers, and don't be afraid to let them know. And the best thing to say to a car salesman that's pushy and trying to get you to purchase a car is, hey, the price here is $35,000, but dealer X has it for $34,000, and they'll give me a discount and let me have it for $30,000. And you can go around and do this to them all day just to see who will go the lowest. I do it all the time. It usually pisses them off because they don't expect you to shop around and it cuts into their already huge profits. But it usually gets them to go down on the price because they need to move the cars off the lot very quickly. So this is the second way that they can and they will rip you off. I used to sell cars and I used to be around a lot of dealers, and so I can tell you, honest car salesmen probably don't exist. If anything, you should be terrified of these guys. But I'm not selling cars anymore, so you can trust me now. Now, the final way in which car dealers will rip you off is with your trade-in. Like I said, I used to sell cars. People will come in with a car and it's dirty and it probably has some major looking or sounding issues. When the dealer knows they can fix it for a few bucks and they know that they can sell this car for a lot. And of course, they're going to tell you that the transmission is blown and the engine needs expensive repairs possibly, but they really know that's not the case. I've seen enough from dealers I know all around. So if a car comes in and the dealer offers you $1,000 for it, I promise you that very same car is worth at least $3,000, if not more. I've gotten cars previously for $400, $500, $650, which the people who are trading them in think they're junk, and instantly I know this car can be cleaned, polished. Maybe if I was feeling generous, then I would actually service the car and then flipped the next day for $3,000 to $4,000 easily. And if I just wanted to flip them fast, then maybe $2,500 and that car is gone. You may visit a used car lot and you'll see a car and the dealer will tell you that it's perfectly fine, but for example, the AC doesn't work, and so he's selling it for $1,000 and he tells you that this car is dependable. Now, that may be true, but don't think he's losing money. He probably paid $150 for it and charged the battery just so it would start and run, and that's all. Sometimes the cars don't even get washed or detailed. So to get around this, always try to sell your cars yourself and don't trade them in, because if the dealer will give you $1,000 for it, someone will happily purchase it for $2,000 to $3,000 quickly, and you have multiple bids and offers for your car, and this is how you actually get double ripped off, because the dealer gives you nothing for your old car and still charges you full price after their so-called discounts on the new car. So try not to get ripped off in any of these ways, and these are things to look out for when you're going to the dealership. And remember, the car dealer is never your friend. Comment below and let me know if you've ever been ripped off by a dealer, or if you were about to be ripped off by a dealer but you somehow avoided it. As always, I hope this video helps you and you found the content valuable. Thanks for watching. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up as it helps the channel a lot. Subscribe and hit the notification bell so you can get the updates every day when I post new videos. And I hope to see you guys tomorrow.